thought I'd do a little bit of talking today. I've been thinking about my project that I was talking about doing, designing and building a Whirligig. It's like any other craft. You can sit down and you can copy somebody else's project, maybe imitate something somebody's already done. But I want to learn the skill of creating Whirligigs. So it'll wind up being a series of projects. I've had some great suggestions from some of my viewers on the locomotive to make the wheels turn. Somebody suggested, I think it was a rusty glove box, using pinwheels for the wheels, which I think is a great suggestion. I've had several nice suggestions. Well, you'll learn how to make a pinwheel. I need to learn the skill of creating propellers if I want any propellers on my various types of Whirligigs I might design. If I could learn the craft of making Whirligigs, I'd be much further off and better off in the long run. Anybody can sit down, cut out a piece of wood, imitate somebody else's video. I like the idea of learning the craft. It's like any other skill I've ever learned. I had to study, practice, and learn it. So it'll wind up being a series of videos before I eventually get around to designing an original Pwalpar Whirligig. Maybe together, if you stick with me on making some of these videos, we'll learn a few things. This is the same drive I make every time I go to the dump. It's not going to be all that different unless something rare happens. There's a lot of factors that go into building Whirligigs, like the durability of the product you make it out of. If you make, use a lot of plywood or laminated wood, it's liable to come apart. The weight is another consideration. Lighter materials will probably work better. And learning this craft of making propellers, I'm sure you wouldn't want anything real heavy. The wind wouldn't turn it unless you got a hurricane going on outside. Every once in a while when I come down this road here, a deer will run out in front of me. We have more deer in accidents crossings in Georgia than ever before. There's plenty of deer around here. And you get ready to go deer hunting, that's a different story. They'll disappear on you. They're there, but they're hard to find, catch. Because their senses are so keen that they can hear you when you come in the woods, and they move on. Trees are really blooming. I'm going to zoom in on some of them before we get back to the house. My wife has made some chicken and dumplings for supper. Figured I'd go ahead and get my dump run over with a little early. I got it up here.
Oh, okay. On this side? don't they? Thank you.
There you go.
I've done a bit of studying on YouTube, watching people's various videos and skills that you can learn by watching other people. I think I got a notion I'm going to go to a hardware store one day and root around in their junk and see what kind of neat products I can incorporate in my designs of whatever Whirligig I come up with. On my train Whirligig that I'm thinking about, I like the idea of the pinwheels for the wheel, to show wheels turning. I want to design probably go with an old style railroad signal, like a wigwag. Wigwag crossing signal would be easy to incorporate into the, have something moving in the Whirligig. You could even do a regular crossing gate going up and down. Somebody mentioned I should maybe put a little fireman shoveling coal in the steam engine. It sounds a little bit technical. You'd have to actually get inside the locomotive. And when you got something working in there, nobody's really going to be able to see it. But you could make some little man popping them down and say he's shoveling coal into the firebox. I made one entirely different, probably. I mentioned this tale before, but I got stopped by the state patrol on this road here a good two or three times. First time, they let me go with a warning because I got out right away and told the highway patrolman, "You got me fair and square, buddy. I was speeding." He said, "You're the first honest person I've talked to all day. I'm gonna let you go with a warning." Which was mighty nice of him. I know when you get out of the car and go to see him, "I wasn't speeding. What did I do wrong, officer?" All he's going to do is start his little pencil writing. He's already got his radar gun and everything else for evidence against you. Why would you get out and lie about it? Nowadays, tickets have gotten so expensive, from what I hear. I haven't had one in a long time. You really don't want to get a ticket. A lot of people getting tickets for some of the dumbest things, like riding around without your seatbelt on. And I grew up in cars that didn't have seatbelts, and nobody wore them. And it was kind of hard to convince people to start using seatbelts. Million reasons why you shouldn't, but you get in one or two wrecks, and I've been in a couple. I can share one with you where I was in a head-on collision in a railroad truck. You learn real quick to believe in wearing your seatbelts. All right, we're home. Thanks for listening.